Ah, and hell yeah, and we're back, and we're just hearing a little Crooked Ways from the band Razorheads. And it's my great pleasure to introduce you all to Flint.
Hi there.
Hey, how you doing today, darling?
I'm fine over here.
Awesome. That's awesome. Well, you know, we got you on my show to talk about Razorheads, and I want you first off to give my listeners a little bit of background about the band.
Okay. So, what you want to know?
Well, I mean, how'd you guys get together? Just give me a little bit of brief history, and then we'll go into some other things.
Okay, yeah, we got together in about 2009, and I've been a sidekick in numerous bands before, but this band is like I wanted to do start my own stuff, and we had the usual lineup changes, which are pretty boring for the outsiders, if you ask me. And the band took decent shape in about 2009. And yeah, played a lot of shows and stuff. And right now the first recording is finished and it just came out in May.
Awesome. And the title of the album is?
Is Razorheads as well.
Awesome. So Razorheads.
Right.
How'd you come up with the name Razorheads anyway?
Yeah, that's like, it's always a pain in the ass to find the right name. We were pretty close to calling ourselves the Bitch Boys.
I love it. Okay.
Yeah. lucky enough, it didn't end up on the table, which is fine with me. And yeah, that name just, you know that when you're like in a state between being awake and asleep somewhere in the middle, some weird ideas come to your mind. You know that?
Yeah.
And yeah, in that kind of state of mind, that name just showed up because I was thinking like, yeah, what do I want to call it? Fucking band then. And yeah, just came to mind, sounded cool. And I Googled it, and it was available. And a lot of people actually afterwards, after we named the band like that, they gave me a lot of explanations what Razorheads actually means. And everybody says a little different kind of little story there, which actually is cool with me. It shows we made a good choice.
Nice. That's really cool. Let me ask you, you just released the album. How's it doing? How you got it?
So far it's doing pretty good. It's like it just came out on 5th of May. The video came out. To tell you the truth, it's like we didn't promote the actual release yet because there's still a little something has to be handled, but it will be made official within the next 2 weeks.
Okay.
So so far it's just the video out with the link there to the album, and so far for not promoting it, it's turning out pretty well.
Nice. About the video, mm-hmm. Definitely. Let's go ahead and talk about that since you brought that up.
I need that.
The video is for a song called "You Don't Deserve Me."
That's right.
Like the name. So first off, let me ask you a little bit. What's the song about lyrically?
It's about basically it's about my ex town and my ex girlfriend. Without crisis, no art.
Awesome. I kind of figured it was along that kind of lines.
The line fit to both the town and the girl, so it's like it works out pretty well.
Nice. There in the video, you know, you got this crongy old looking boat captain, and you guys are taking off. Where are you going to? Is that leaving the town?
Yeah. It's like I leave that up to the viewer. It's like I wanted to keep it a little vague. It's like we got a little joke at the end of the video there. And maybe check it out. The captain himself, he's an old friend of ours. He's not an actor or some bullshit like that. He's a real captain. He's having a tugboat here in the Hamburg harbor, and he was a good friend of mine, and we hung out on board there a lot, having a couple of beverages there. And I think only idiots would not have shot a video there. It's like it was like that.
it's very cool, you guys playing on the boat. It had to be done.
It's like hanging out there. It was so obvious that we just had to shoot a video on there. And the song itself, it matched quite well. And I think it turned out pretty kick-ass.
Nice. You know, I noticed one thing in that video that was really kind of cool. And I don't know how many people would notice it, but you're playing a black guitar and you have a sticker for potential.
Ah, you saw that.
Yeah, right. You got a sticker for potential threat on there. I was like, wow, that's awesome. So full circle here. Tell me about your ties to potential threat, because, you know, I just interviewed them.
Yeah. That's actually why we're talking here. It's like the bond there is like that. It's basically my ex band from Europe here. They lived in Germany, and I'm from Germany, and we had a band over here. And when they moved back to San Francisco, I organized three tours for them over here. They're still good friends. And it's like I booked the shows over here, played a bunch of shows over here together. Hopefully it works out in California as well, and in the States to do a bunch of shows together. So it's they're still like brothers to me. It's my ex band. We still got good contact there.
Awesome.
And the sticker definitely deserved a place in the video there, of course.
That is so cool. It's definitely cool. What other cool things happened when you were shooting the video? You're standing up there and the boat's moving. Was it actually moving? I mean, the whole time you're playing?
Sure.
Did anything weird?
No Photoshop or digital effects there. Just rode the fucking boat all over the harbor, and we shot it actually with two boats. But the tugboat was a little smaller, a little slower, which the band was on, and we had a speedboat circling around it with a second camera, and we cut it together in the end.
Okay.
And now it's all for real. No digital effects there. It's like old school.
Nice. But what I was asking, was there any like things that at the beginning that where it was kind of like tough to figure out, you know, standing on a boat while it's moving and playing and all that stuff? And was it really slow?
No, it wasn't. Actually, we had to slow it down a little bit actually in the movie, because it looked too fast. And my ancestors there from seafaring nations, so it was kind of easy to stand on there. It's all in the blood, I guess.
Oh, you're Mr. Viking.
Yeah, as well.
Nice. See, I'm the perfect person to interview you then, because I'm a Valkyrie and you're in Viking.
Cool.
Okay. You were telling me another thing about one of the other songs on here, and I found it was a really interesting story. So, you know, I wanted you to talk about it. I'm really afraid I'm going to fuck up the name of this song. Zombies of the Reeperbahn.
There you go. Zombies of the Reeperbahn. Close enough. All right.
Nice. Okay, so this one, is it sung in German too, the whole song?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's pardon me?
In the union. So what's this song about? Tell me.
Yeah, basically, it had to be done in German. I tried it in English, but it really sounded like shit. And it's my first German song, actually. And the story behind that is, we got a little time, right?
Talk, yeah, go.
Okay.
Talk. I'm not going to shut you. I'll tell you when you need to shut up, okay?
All right, please tell me. You're always welcome.
Talk.
That's a little something behind there. I try to cut it short. It's a friend of mine. He painted a comic book here on art school as his for his master's degree or whatever it's called, and he made that comic book. It's called Zombies of the Reeperbahn, Zombies on the Reeperbahn. The Reeperbahn is the heart of the whorehouse red light district here in Hamburg, for the fellas who don't know it. And we had this comic first, and I knew the guy who painted it. And he asked me, "Hey, Flint, would you like to do a song for that?" Because he was thinking about some kind of vague multimedia project, blah, blah, which didn't have a clear shape back then. But, so he gave me the comic book. I checked it out, and it was a fucking great piece of art. I really dug it. And it was pretty easy to write a song to that. The lyrics deal with a lot of stuff that happens in the comic book. And the funny thing, another funny thing, there's a character in the comic book that reminds of a famous German rapper. He's called Ferris MC. And I had contact with him, and I gave him a call, said, yeah, we were doing a song that comic that you're actually in, which he didn't know by
okay.
then. And yeah, he said, yeah, so, send me the comic, I'll check it out. He checked it out, I sent him a rough mix of the song, and he dug it, and 2 days later, we were in the studio.
Nice.
And yeah. That's the audio side of the project, the video side of it. It's like the song turned out that great that we said to ourselves, we got to shoot a video to that. And I'm having an audio and video production firm myself. So we thought like, okay, let's keep it thrashy like the song. So we organized a zombie flash mob in the Horror House district over here for the shooting of the video. And we were expecting like or maybe 100 people there. And when we hooked up there, there was like 150 undead fellows there dressed up like zombies. So this was on Halloween. And we just basically walked up and down the Horrors district with three cameras to shoot the people, basically without knowing what was going to happen. But I think the interactions between the zombies and the guys who were loaded as fuck on the Reeperbahn turned out just fine. So it was hard to decide which material we should choose from there, because it was all pretty good.
Nice. That's and, very cool.
So I'm afraid I couldn't make it shorter.
And then don't worry about it. That's very cool. Definitely. How that song came about. So what I want to do now is I want to play Zombies Off the Reeperbahn.
All right.
And I want to play You Don't Deserve Me.
All right.
All right. So, and then we're going to come back and ask you some more questions. So,
all right. Crank it up.
Yeah. Turn it up. Crank it up. And rock it the fuck. Oh, hell yeah. Awesome tunes. Definitely awesome tunes. And a really interesting story about the song that I'm having. Okay. you know, but you're talking about, you know, all this multimedia stuff that went along with happened after this guy approached you.
Yeah.
Where can people see this? Is it out yet, or?
It's actually what you can see as we speak. It's a trailer out there, a video trailer. The full thing, it's going to be about 10 or 12 minutes long. It's like almost a short movie. It will be released in roundabout autumn of 2013. And if you want to be kept updated or check it out, I would recommend to go to our headquarters, www.razorheads.com. You find it all there. Links to our Facebook site, to our got a YouTube site. All the trailers are on there. For the Western as well, we did Western. And yeah, check out razorheads.com. It's all there.
.com. I like what you say, .com. Razorheads.com. Guys, you definitely need to go check that out. I'm sure that with razorheads.com that you have all kinds of stuff up there. Do you have like merch and stuff on your website?
Yeah, it's all in the making. It's all in the making. We're setting up a web shop as we speak. And it should be online in June. Right. You can buy the CD there as well, your old school. It's distributed via CD Baby America.
Okay.
Get it there. And we just got T-shirts and stuff yesterday, and we're hard working on setting up the web shop for that. We'll be there in the near future.
Nice. Okay, so your T-shirts. Did you think of the girls when you designed T-shirts?
Sure.
I mean, do you have something like a V-neck that we or something, or do we have to cut it all up?
yeah. That's another thing I learned while we were thinking about the merch. It's like the V-neck, because I'm male, and I never heard about a thing called the V-neck, but I'm a little old-fashioned, maybe. And yeah, it's all there. You can get it all girly sizes up to 2XL for the fat motherfuckers. It's all there.
Oh, really? 2XL for fat motherfuckers. Okay, do you have 3XL for the but really? Oh, I can't believe you said that. That's not nice. Okay. I know you're just fucking around. Okay, so all the cool shirts. These days also I really cool thing, you're gonna have patches and all the other stuff eventually.
Yeah, it's all in the making.
Oh,
We're
okay.
just starting off with shirts and stuff, and I think we actually did a song called "Black Socks Get You Laid." So the idea is there to publish an extra Black Socks Razorhead edition with a name on it or something, because the song's out there anyway and wouldn't make perfect sense, so to say.
Okay, Black Sox. Yeah, that song is funny. There's a you that's what I was gonna say something about. With your names of your songs, you got like this thing like really fun names, and I don't know how I'm lost on the word I'm searching for, but how do you come up with some of these names for these songs that you got, like "Fuck You, That's My Name," "Black Socks Get You Laid." Does now is that black socks and black panties and black bra?
some people already suggested to us to make a concept album starting with the socks and ending up with a hat, which would be a double vinyl album then. We're thinking about it. Not.
Nice. Are you thinking about vinyl?
Yeah, the plan is like we got to see how the sales work with the CD and downloads and stuff, because it's ain't that cheap to do vinyl. I'd love to do vinyl, but it's all DIY style with us. We ain't got the support of a big record company or something like that. So we got to see how it works with the CD, and if they're doing good, we definitely do vinyl there. But we're not rich. And it's going to cost some coin if you do it. At least it's that way over here. Ain't cheap.
Right. So you're pretty much self supported, or do you have any kind of backings?
No, it's basically we do it all ourselves, because I think maybe it's in the year 88 made sense to have a record company, but nowadays if you got a good team around you don't need it actually.
No, that's
I
true.
think we got a good promotion agency who's taking care of that stuff, called Albagi Promotions. They're doing a great job, and we just got a booking agent on board. That's what you need, and yeah, there's CDs out there anyway.
Right.
And if I look at the shares that people usually used to get in with a classic record. Record deal and the amount of money that's left there today, if you do it yourself, it's like yeah, I think only stupid people signed an 80s contract, because you're getting ripped off.
Right.
Unless you're somebody who's like a lazy kind of superstar guy who's is used to getting pampered by everybody, then you might do a good decision and get ripped off by a record company. But I think it's outdated. It's over.
Okay, so who produced your album?
Me.
Awesome. So do you do
Yep.
that for a living too, or what do you do for a living?
I'm trying actually. I didn't produce it myself. We did the rough tracks in our studio, and I did the final mixing in a studio here in Hamburg with a good friend of mine. I co-produced from that point on. Because he's got better technical skills than me, and he's faster, and we kind of did it together. I showed up there with the rough tracks, and we mixed and mastered it in his studio over here, Absolute Studios.
Cool. Now, you said you brought on a booking agent. All right. So what you got for shows coming up?
It's all in the making now. It's like We're trying to concentrate on doing a bunch of festival shows over here. I don't know what it's like in the States, but over here it's really it ends working to play clubs in the summer, because no one goes there. It's too hot and too sticky or whatever. So we're trying to get as many shows as possible over here in autumn in the clubs. There's already a little something coming up there. It's all in the making. And we got plans to go out to the States as well. Actually, our bass player is over there as we speak. He's in L.A. right now, making a little connection to friends over there. And hopefully it works out with the States as well one day.
Cool. Cool. And with maybe I'll see you on tour with Potential Threat.
Yeah. Yeah. That would be a blast. Yeah.
Nice. What would you say, bands that influences you?
Oh, yeah. We got a little time, right?
Well, I mean, okay. There's so many genres out there these days. And, we all have our opinions on what we think music, falls into. In fact, I don't like a lot of them because I mean, think they get a little redundant. But, what influenced you? What kind of style do you feel that your music is? For if you was just to describe it to somebody that may not know your music.
Yeah, it's like my favorite catchphrase there is metal's called it punk, punk's called it metal. It's what I hear from other people because it's hard to describe it yourself when you did the song yourself. So I think it's somewhere between stoner rock, punk, hardcore, and metal. It's loud guitars and we're like looting our way through 40 years of music history and whatever rocks will take them. Nice. And I basically leave it up to other people to think about it in genres. It's classical music, musician's answer, but I can't help it because it's true.
Nice. Where's the next show you got lined up for, anybody in your area that happens to be listening?
The next show we got, that's in July 21st. It's on a festival here in the Hamburg area. It's open air festival. It's one of the ones we do this summer. It's 21st of July. It's called Deichpiraten Festival.
Deichpiraten. Deichpiraten. Okay.
The Levy Pirate Festival.
Nice.
So Levy break.
So July 21st. Gosh, I wish I would be over there. That's like the weekend before my birthday. Damn. Oh. Okay. Well, I know I'm going to get to see you soon out there playing, and I definitely want to have you back on the show. Sometime in the future we get to talk more stuff.
I would be delighted.
Is there anything else that you would like to say to the listeners out there listening today?
I think I got a last one left. It's because it's a kind of an American subject, actually, because we shot another video as well, which is coming out later.
Okay, go ahead. No, I'm sorry. Another video. So we're going to get like.
Yeah, it's the zombie movie is coming up next. And after that, it's a short movie, Western. And we a good friend of mine, his name is Wilson Gill from Santa Barbara. He's got a kick-ass new band called the DTs. Check him out.
Nice.
And he's an old American friend of mine. And we did a cover version of the song. It's called Sam Hall. I don't know. Most of the people know the Johnny Cash version. It's like...
Okay. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Sorry.
I'm sure you know it when you hear it. It's a classic and everybody knows it, but it's not from Johnny Cash. It's actually a 400-year-old outlaw song. And we collaborated with Wilson Gill on that one. We shared the vocals and a bunch of other friends over here. And we made a black and white western out of it. It's like a short movie. And that one's coming out as well. And there's a trailer out there as well on www.razorheads.com.
Razorheads.com. We're back there. Yeah, we can't forget to say the razorheads.com. Okay.
Right.
You want to say bye to listeners? Thank you for anything else?
No, it's my 20 cents here.
All right, darling, it was really great to have you. And like I said, anytime you want to come back, we'll just get you back on here and we'll talk some more. Maybe when you release some of these videos, we can have you back on and we'll talk about the release of it and how it's doing, right?
All right, then.
Right. Awesome. Until then, everybody go by and check out Razorheads.com. And we are going to have one more song. It's called Fuck You, That's My Name. Oh, that's an awesome name to have. Fuck You, That's My Name. Turn it up, crank it up. And